Hello, welcome to this segment of Old Channel Old Health. I'm your dietitian Jeremy.
I'm a nutritionist Wen Xin.
So Wen Xin, today we have an exciting topic to talk about. It's really exciting. Okay, why? Because when we talk about it, we accept zap zap. what is this zap zap all about?
It's about electricity
and
the topic.
Shock.
Yeah, actually it's static shock. I believe that this phenomenon. Mm-hmm. Most of the people you may experience once or twice or even more in your lifetime.
Yes, correct. Yeah, because I used to actually notice whenever in an environment where it is very dry, you know, mm-hmm. because nowadays we are all sitting indoors, okay, we seldom go outdoors, and then we are a lot facing all these electronic gadgets, laptops, handphones, and then we are in air-conditioned room where it can be very, very dry.
Yeah.
So I used to find that whenever I want to open the door or my door of my car, I will actually feel the little zap zap from touching the metal. The metal. So it's actually not very comfortable, and it's actually quite shocking also. And sometimes when we walk past our friends, you know, sometimes we actually touch our elbow, and also we have that zap kind of feeling. So we're like, oh, who actually has the electrostatic charges or static shock?
Yeah, I remember when I was back in school, I don't know if it's primary school teacher or kindergarten teacher, they taught us some thing about physics, mm-hmm. electricity, mm-hmm. and they did a very fun experiment with balloon and hair.
Okay.
So the teacher actually, she rubbed the balloon, the balloon on hair mm-hmm. for a few times to create the friction.
Then
after that, when she take away the balloon mm-hmm. and come again close to the hair will like attracted to the balloon.
Yes, correct.
Floating.
Yeah, so this is actually, if you have watched Mr. Bean before, so actually Mr. Bean, there was one episode where he actually went back to school and then there was some experiment going on. So he was actually going on in that electric thing which actually generate a lot of static charges,
mm-hmm.
but when he touched, it doesn't have any effect on the hair. Probably his hair is too hard, so mm-hmm. it doesn't go up. But when after that, when he walks around and then he can actually feel the electrostatic charges, you can actually hear this kind of sound. But this is actually more of the most severe cases of static charges in our body. Now, some of you may be thinking that electrostatic can be anywhere, can happen mm-hmm. anywhere. It can be coming from internal, it can be coming from external. And aside from feeling a bit uncomfortable mm-hmm. with the zap, it can also actually lead to some of the health concerns or health issues. Well, some studies actually found that if your body actually accumulates a lot of these static charges, it can actually interfere how our heart actually beats. Yeah, because our heart is actually beating on an electric current, okay? There's a pace to it. But if there's an excessive electric going on, okay, conductivity in your body, that may be interfering with the heartbeat. And also, it can also affect how your red blood cells work, where they actually may clump together instead of, you know, going one by one, but mm-hmm. they all clump together and it becomes very hard for them to move around and also to transport oxygen. Now, these are some of the things that we need to actually take cautious of.
Yeah, but before that, some of you mm-hmm. may wonder, what is static shock actually?
Yep.
As we know, actually all the things on the earth is mm-hmm. made of matter.
Yep,
and matter,
correct.
We have atoms.
Yep.
And inside atoms, actually we have a negative charge, we have positive charge.
Positive charge.
Yeah, electrons, protons, and then the neutrons.
Mm-hmm.
So normally those electric charges, they will be in a balanced state.
Yes,
yeah,
correct.
But when there are
a lot of positive.
Yeah, maybe a lot of positive or a lot of negative mm-hmm. charges accumulate on a surface of something, then it is called static electricity.
Yes.
And when these electrons, maybe this material has a lot of electrons on the surface,
mm-hmm.
and another material, it has a lot of protons on the surface. Mm-hmm. So when these two opposite charges come together, they will attract,
okay.
and there will be transfer of these electrons from one to another. Then that's when you have static shock.
Yes, correct. So now that you have learned about the static shocks and probably you have actually had some experience before, probably you can also share with us at the comment section. Let us know how static shock can be one of the very nuisance things in your life, right? So now that we know static shock is really, really annoying.
Really annoying.
Okay. So why am I getting static shock so easily? Okay, what are the reasons behind it?
Yeah, people may be wondering because Jeremy and I, mm-hmm. maybe Jeremy is easily to get static shock, but me, I'm not.
Not you, alright?
Yeah, not me, mm-hmm. but why? Actually, there are a few reasons. The first one is body is sensitive to low range shock. Means yes. that we have different body type. Means that we also have a different sensitivity. Yeah, to the shock. Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe in the same condition, Jeremy will mm-hmm. feel the shock.
Yes.
But me, I'm not feeling
yes.
that.
It depending on the body nature, sometimes when the sensitivity is very low, meaning that even with the electric static charges is very low, very mild, mm-hmm. but people with very low sensitivity can even get it, okay, or they are very sensitive to it, they can actually get the shock from it.
Yeah, mm. another one is body may be storing more static electricity than others due to size of feet, body attire, and mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, because if you imagine if someone is bigger size, right, probably they are 6 feet tall, right? And of course, with 6 feet tall and probably bigger surface area, mm-hmm. and there's a tendency for you to actually accumulate more static charges. Or even if you have a larger feet, of course, your contact area with yeah. the ground on the floor is even bigger, so it's easier for your body to attract electrostatic charges as well.
Yeah, and the third one will be body may be generating more charges than others due to certain habits such as walking weight and etc.
Yes, so when we talk about walking weight, well, just talking about Wen Xin just now, what kind of walking weights, you know, can actually lead to this? I was actually thinking that walking weights could be, you know, the person is walking with the legs rubbing against each other. You know, somebody, they want to walk very elegantly. Uh-huh. You know, they want to, you know, look like, elegantly so that your legs sort of like, you know, close to each other, touching mm-hmm. to each other, and the way you walk. So there's a lot of friction going on when you walk this way. But apparently it's not this. It's actually there's another reason.
Yeah, you found out some people when they won't really lift up their feet entirely.
Yes.
They're like dragging their feet all mm-hmm. along the way. And when if you are wearing slippers, you heard the sound.
Yes,
they're
yes.
dragging
yes.
the slippers all the way. Mm-hmm.
So this is something what we call as lazy feet.
Yeah,
yeah. Some people, they don't like to walk. You know, they don't want to lift up their legs. So when you drag your feet, alright, so there's a lot of frictions going on. So apparently if you're walking barefoot, alright, directly on the ground, or even if you're wearing something like socks, but mm-hmm. it's made of a synthetic fiber material, it can actually create a lot of friction with the ground, and therefore these static charges will be transferred to your body.
Yeah, actually mm. not only walking, it's anything with your lifestyle habit. For example, the way you mm-hmm. sit, maybe you like to rub against the chair
okay.
when you sleep laying on the bed, then you okay. like to turn around, then it create a lot of friction, then mm-hmm. it give you a lot of chances to accumulate these charges.
Yes, correct. Because sometimes when I talk about these habits, I was thinking like sometimes if your back feels itchy, uh-huh. and you don't have anyone to actually help you to, you know, scratch your back, so probably you can just lean against a chair and then you start, you know, going like this to scratch and then to relieve your itchiness. Now, this is also one of the reasons, or maybe one of the factors, why you actually create a lot of these static charges in your body.
Yeah, so this 3 points is about mm-hmm. physically and the habits. And next, yep. we have something more internally, for example, yep. like the body fluid imbalance.
Yes, so we know that actually this coming from the TCM, traditional Chinese medicine theory, because in our body, alright, we have different organs. Mm-hmm. So one of the organs that actually control the fluid balance, as we know, is kidneys, alright? So kidneys controls the fluid balance, control the movement of blood in our body. So, if there is a kidney insufficiency, or we say the qi, kidney qi is not enough, so therefore there will be a lot of compromisation on the fluid balance in our body. So, when your body is lacking in fluid, definitely the transport of blood, transfer of nutrients will be affected as well. And the static charges tend to stay in your body much more easier or even longer.
Yeah, so actually, sometimes static shock is just not about, it's not entirely about the way that your habits, mm-hmm. Maybe your body type. Actually, it's all related to your diet
yes,
and
correct.
Your lifestyle habits.
Yes, correct. Sometimes some people, they like to drink coffee, for example, or even caffeinated drinks. So we all know that caffeinated drinks, they are diuretics, meaning they tend to promote more water excretion from the body. And if you're the type that you don't like to drink plain water, meaning you only drink those coffee tea mm-hmm. as a daily beverage, you can get dehydrated very easily. So when there is a lack of water in your body, so there is a tendency for you to actually accumulate these static charges as well.
Yes, so talking about diet, talking about lifestyle habits, some people, I believe that most working adults, mm-hmm. or no matter young or old, mm-hmm. Especially when there are some projects mm-hmm. and deadline, they will like stay overnight.
Yes, correct. And burning midnight oil.
Yeah, burning midnight oil. If in the long term consequences, that body will be in a state of a chronic deprivation.
Yes, correct. And when people staying overnight, you know, burning midnight oil, what they do, actually when they get hungry, then probably they will just get some instant noodles or they will just order some fast food.
Drinking coffee.
Yeah, drinking coffee. So all these processed foods and of course, they may be lacking in fruits and vegetables intake. So can actually lead to your body coming to the next stage, which is depriving your body from oxygen. So when your body is not having enough oxygen, and if you are taking a lot of meat or animal-based products, definitely it's going to bring your body into a state of acidity.
Yes, so actually if you are getting a static shock quite frequent, you may want to start to think twice. It is something with your body, your body pH, your diet, imbalance. So we'll proceed to the next
yes, correct.
One.
So we all know that what we say body acidity, whenever people talk about body acidity, it's not about your blood pH, okay, going into become acidic. Okay, because we all know that our body pH, our blood pH is within the normal range of 7.35 to 7.45, and it's very tightly regulated by different organs, including our lungs, okay, our kidneys. These are the two main organs that actually control the acid and alkaline base balance in our body. But when we talk about body acidity, it simply means that your body is accumulating a lot of these hydrogen ions, okay? And your blood pH becomes very near, okay, very near to 7.35, but it's not below 7.35. Because when your blood pH goes below 7.35, you are going to say bye-bye, alright? So this is the thing that we need to emphasize. So meaning, if your body is acidic, meaning to say your blood pH is very close to 7.35, and what happens, okay, when you actually have this issue? Let's see.
Yeah, just now we mentioned about chronic deprivation. One of it, if you have feel tired, if you stay
lethargic
or early, actually you might have chronic oxygen deprivation due to prolonged body exhaustion. And we know that actually our cells will breathe. It's called cell respiration.
Yes, correct.
In a condition with lacking of oxygen, the cell will came into a state of like anaerobic respiration, and
yes,
that
correct.
They will produce a lot of
lactic acid,
this waste. And if let's say if your body metabolism is not good and the body couldn't excrete all the carbon dioxide and lactic acid out, then it will accumulate in your blood. Then you will have accumulation of these hydrogen ions and increased acidity of your blood.
Yes, correct. So when we talk about lactic acid, okay, just think of a way, like for example, when we do exercise, right? For example, for a long time we didn't do, and suddenly we go back to into exercises, and you probably noticed you have some muscle sore, you know, for at least 2 to 3 days, and it's actually due to the accumulation of lactic acid in your body. And eventually, when this lactic acid, after they have been metabolized, and that's where your muscle sore will subside. But imagine your body is constantly having this lactic acid, or this lactic acid keeps in your body for a very long period of time, meaning your muscles, your body cells, they are in a state of exhaustion, alright? They are very tired, okay? They cannot replenish their metabolism. So that especially leads to the accumulation of these hydrogen ions, and eventually your blood becomes more acidic, okay? More acidic meaning it's closer to the 7.35.
Yeah, so what's the consequences of having a more acidic blood? First, you will experience static shock more frequent, because this accumulation of hydrogen ion will increase the risk of static shock, which means that the transfer.
Yes,
more,
correct.
Yeah,
meaning you have more hydrogen ions on your skin surface. Definitely when you touch another surface that is made from metal, definitely there will be some exchange of ions going on. So when there's an exchange, there comes the static shock.
Yeah. Aside from the static shock, actually accumulation of hydrogen ion will cause the imbalance of electrons within the cells. Because that when imagine this is a cell. Cell actually they have an imbalanced state of positive and negative charge.
Yes, correct.
When the environment, outer environment is with a lot of hydrogen ion positive charge, then it will like take away the negative charge from the cell. Then
to neutralize the effects.
Yeah. Then the cell will undergo a state of free radical damage.
Yes, because when we say about free radicals, meaning the cells become very unstable, or there are some unstable ions or molecules that come and attack our cells. So our cells also become a little bit unstable, and then they start to malfunction. So this will all make the cells become inflamed, okay, mm-hmm. or malfunction, or they actually die. So imagine if the cells in your body, you know, it's normal for cells to change over, right, day in, day out, okay? But when there is a lot of these free radicals happening, it can actually trigger something called the cancer, okay, or abnormality in terms of your blood cells, okay, in terms of your blood vessels, even to your lung cells, it can actually cause a lot of these allergic reactions or asthma, or even gums. Because some people actually find that if people actually have a lot of electrostatic charges, they can get a lot of this gum inflammation. So they get a lot of these periodontal diseases, which can actually, coming to think about it, even static charges can lead to poor gum health.
Yeah, not only that, and this imbalance of charge actually will lead to fatigue due to inefficient transfer of oxygen into normal cells, and also aggregation of red blood cells and low oxygen exchange rate.
Yeah, so meaning to say that if your red blood, like we mentioned just now, the red blood cell should be free and easy, you know, carrying all the oxygen by itself. And when all the red blood cells come and clump together, alright, imagine you have all those blastocytes, you know, they all come together. So it becomes very hard, you know, they are very rigid, and then they cannot move very fast. You know, the blood vessels are so tiny, and then they have to squeeze through. Eventually, there are a lot of issues, okay, with the blood transport and blood flow. So if you don't have enough blood, okay, flowing into your brain, what will happen? You probably have some stroke, okay, probably you have, probably the lighter ones will be the, you know, feeling, you know, you will yawn, you will sleep, you become sleepy, and etc.
Yeah, so this is a relation between body acidity, static shock, and chronic illness.
Yes,
so next, we'll proceed to how to eliminate these static electrical charges in our daily life. Actually.
Yeah, so we can actually see the first one will be to wear low static fabrics and shoes, such as cotton clothing and leather shoes. So we all know that, for example, cotton and wool, they are actually very soft, okay, they can actually neutralize the charges in your body. But if you're wearing something like synthetic fibers, okay, or polyesters, so this can actually lead to a lot of static charge creation, alright, happening around. So if you want to safeguard your body from these static charges, you can actually go for cotton or even wool based of fabrics.
Not only the static charges, actually wearing this natural material, those clothing and shoes made of natural materials can allow your skin to breathe.
Yes, correct. So it's very important, otherwise your skin will become very dry and then very dull, you know. So you can actually use cotton fabrics for a healthier skin as well.
Yeah, next one we have use skin moisturizer and hair conditioner.
So we all know actually this coming from also with the next one is actually the humidify the air by using air humidifier or bringing some plants around the house. Why? Because sometimes as we mentioned, we are not sitting in air conditioned room, okay, most of the time for at least 8 hours at work, and then go back home, probably we use another round of air conditioning, and then we sleep also, sometimes we use the aircon, right? So this can actually create a very dry environment. So you can actually apply skin moisturizer, okay, you know, probably 3 to 4 times a day to maintain the skin hydration, and also to actually use hair moisturizer, because hair is one of the thing that can actually attract a lot of these static charges.
Yeah, actually, if the environment air is very cold, means that there's less water droplets in air. And water droplet actually is quite a good conductor.
Yep.
So if the water droplets in the air is sufficient, then it will like helps to take away those excessive charges in your body. So
yes,
you won't
correct.
Have those static shock so easily.
Correct. So if you want to maintain a very a healthy humidity in the room, you can actually try to maintain between 50 to 55%. Try not to bring below 40%, because it's actually quite dangerous, and aside from static shock, it can actually lead to a lot of issues. Some that I heard before that actually when it was very dry in the kitchen, okay, when you actually use flour, okay, the normal wheat flour, so when you actually pour out the flour, so because flour is a very light and dry material, so if the air environment is actually also very dry and it's actually rich in all this static material, so it can actually cause combustion or fire sparks. So it can become a fire hazard in the kitchen as well. So you have to take note that the room humidity itself, you have to keep between 50 to 55%, and how to do it, you can actually use a humidifier, of course, or nowadays, the aircon also is actually, you can actually use the cool mode, which actually comes with a humidifying, property as well.
Yeah, so those with air conditioning in your house, remember to use a humidifier, and also actually not only to prevent aesthetic shock, sometimes it helps to protect your skin because
yes,
your skin will become very dry.
Yeah, you don't want to have cracks all around. Or if you don't want to have a humidifier, you can actually just simply put a glass of water in the room. Alright, when you sleep, so when there's glass of water and there will be evaporation going on, so there will be some water vapor, so the room itself won't be too dry.
Yeah, okay, next one we will have adding softener or baking soda to your laundry. This is also one of the tips to help to dispel all the charges accumulating on your clothes fabrics.
Yes, correct. So when you wash your clothes, yeah, when you dry your clothes, so there will be some fabrics friction going on as well. So by using softener, so this can actually help to dispel the charges from the fabrics. And next?
Next, carry around something metal such as keychain or touch the wall to transfer away the charges. I believe Jeremy has a story to tell.
Okay, so this actually, while I don't carry those metal or you know keychain to actually relieve my static charges, but what I normally do, because knowing that I always get zapped from touching the car door, so I'll actually use either my wallet or actually I use my my handphone with a plastic cover to actually open the door so that it actually helps to prevent myself from getting zapped with the car at the door. But another one that I'm doing actually is the next one, which is connect with Mother Nature, such as walking barefoot on grass and hugging trees. Now, of course, for now I don't actually walk barefoot on grass, but what I do is whenever I feel like having these static charges, I will actually just touch the trees with my bare hand. Alright, I'll just touch the trees and I'll just touch for about 30 seconds to 1 minute. And this it can actually help to relieve the static charges. It's the same when you want to, you know, walk barefoot on the grass. You can actually walk for about 5 to 10 minutes every morning. Alright, this can actually help to release the static charges to the earth as well.
Yeah, actually it's called earthing. I think I believe that a few years ago, many people, especially those living in city, busy working, sometimes they will have insomnia or they have some uncomfortable on their body. Then they will go to trekking and then hugging a big tree.
Yes, correct.
The group of people or just walking on the grass barefoot because these are all the activities can help to discharge all the charges accumulating in the body.
Yes, correct. When talking about outdoors, going to parks, sometimes they go to waterfall. You know, waterfall because of the force of the water flowing down. There's a lot of this. Negative ions in the environment. So when you get into that area, this can actually help to release the positive ions from your body. So this can actually be neutralized as well. So it's actually very, very good when you actually go to a waterfall area and actually helps to get all the negative ions from the waterfall area.
Yeah, so the nature, the earth is a very good choice because not just helping you to dispel all the charges, and if you're in that situation, looking at those jungles, trees, waters, you feel so relaxed. Actually.
Yes, and birds chirping, and most importantly, it's free. Okay, it's FOC. So you're walking on grass is free also, alright? Just make sure the grass is clean, alright? No muddy things, alright? And you can actually walk safely on the grass, alright? So next one we have
reduce the frequency of using electronic devices.
Yes, well, I guess this is inevitable because even that you have to work from home, even children nowadays, they have to use electronic gadgets to attend online classes and whatnot. So if you can, right, as you say, if you want to use electronic devices, make sure you actually control the time, or you actually whenever you use for about 1 to 2 hours, okay, you step away, right? Probably you do something, you touch something, alright? Not, of course, not like, you know, touching some plastic material where it's going to create more frictions, but you can actually go and, you know, just touch the trees for 30 seconds. It's very, very fast. This can actually help to prevent the static charges build up in your body.
Yeah, and try not to use electronic devices 1 to 2 hours before your sleep because it's found to affect your sleeping quality.
Yes,
many
correct.
People are facing with this problem.
Yes, correct. And many actually have this habit of using handphones before sleep, which is actually quite disturbing to your sleep pattern as well. So the last one.
Lastly, drink plenty of water, eat more vegetables and fruits for their minerals and vitamins.
Yes, correct. So the first one, as we say, if your body is lacking in water, so water is a very good a way of dispelling charges in your body. So, just something we missed out also. If you are having these issues with electrostatic charges, okay, we always recommend you to wash your hands more often. So, with the running water, so the running water can actually remove or bring away the charges from your body. So, water helps a lot with taking care of the charges in our body. What about the fruits and vegetables?
Actually, fruits and vegetables contain a lot of vitamins and minerals. Mm-hmm. And these vitamins and minerals, actually, it is found to help to dispel charges as well. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because these minerals, they are mostly alkaline in nature. So remember we said just now, if you are a meat eater, okay, if you're not eating enough fruits and vegetables, your body will be in a state of acidity, right? Very near to 7.35. But today, if you eat more fruits and vegetables, because of the minerals, which can make them as an alkaline food. Mm-hmm. So this alkaline food can actually help to bring your pH closer to the normal range, which is still within 7.35 to 7.45, but it's away from the 7.35.
Yeah, so at the end of our session, we still recommend you to eat healthily with more vegetables and fruits as well.
Yes, of course. Of course, a healthy balanced meal would be the most appropriate and most ideal for everyone.
Yeah, so salad shop actually is quite annoying and despite just finding ways to eliminate those habits or finding ways to reduce the risk of getting into salad shop, sometimes eating healthily, just like I said, is very...
Yes, it's helpful in any...
It's in almost everything,
alright? So we can see it actually all comes into your diet, your lifestyle and your exercise or even your mental health as well. Alright, so I guess that's all for sharing today. So thank you very much for joining us on this segment of Old Health. If you like our sharing, do like, comment and share, and of course subscribe to our channel. And most importantly, you have to share this with someone you care and you love and you know they are bothered by aesthetic shock. Please share with them.
Yeah, before we end, I think we should announce something. I think this is our last... We should say goodbye to our viewers, isn't it?
Yes, this is essentially our last segment of Old Health on Old Channel. We are running into 1 year into this program, and we all hope that you have benefited from our sharing all this year long. And of course, okay, don't be disappointed because we still have our segments going on and we are going to still share with you a lot of this health information or sharing with you, with our audience. And there will be an exciting program lineup waiting for you as well, alright? So do stay tuned to our program, alright? Do stay tuned to our social media and we hope to see you again next round. Okay, stay safe, take care always.
See you, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.